reason provoke
We've taken all of the American AC 386 because that's important for code compliance in America.
我们把386的所有标准都放进去了，因为这个是在北美是必须的。
And we have taken parts of the JC 688, if I got the numbers right.
采用了一部分的中国886的灵美协会688的灵美协会的标准。
Yeah, we know that we need to do more work on this standard. Because we have to make it suitable for Canada and America, and our goal is for other countries as well.
这一版还需要修改，因为这个是适用于北美整个的标准。
Our
one thing I want to say is that I assembled this document.But I am not.
Mike 想说的说 ，Mike 他做的这个标准。
But I'm not an expert on magnesium oxide board.
但是他自己不是氧化镁方面的专家。
So some of the numbers in there are an estimate.
所以有些这个标准里边的有些数据，他是他自己做的一个估值估计的。
So I need the input from others to know what the right number is.
所以大家如果知道具体的应该是什么值的话，把它写录进来就可以了。大家转过来好不好？咱不需要看那儿了吧？
先拍照。
不需要看了。
他们进口来人不是还要？
咱这不讨论这个什么吗？
文字稿。
Yeah.
Okay.
或者你们坐过来。
坐来。
This is a discussion, so let's move around.
翻个身来就可以吗？
赵主任，
给
他翻译。他参考应该参考那个接地气414王所长制定的标准，就八八也不专业。
Oh, Peter.
一般什么
标
准？
把那个
岳
飞
制定的。Engineer Wang, Engineer Zhang, Zhang says that you guys should prove.Should refer to the standard of, what's the name?
Wang Zifu.
Yeah, Wang Zifu's standard on what? 这个王所做的那个标准的名字叫什么？
它这个编号是 JGT
414。
414. There, we have a Chinese standard. Instead, you referred to Mike. You referred to the standard of 866, and we, in fact, he says there's another one even more professional, you know.
Okay.
And it's 414.
I have no knowledge about that. I don't have a Chinese copy.
他也不是没有中文版，他也不知道。
我现在给。
He'll give you now. Give it.
Oh, okay.
In Chinese, I guess.
Yeah. Well, the 688. I had to hire somebody to translate.
但是他可以给他。
U 盘。
Do you have a computer, Mike? Yeah. 给他。
Okay, she's printing. I'm going to go get my pad.
多参考两，这个目前的一个进
度。这个标准啊，我和我们国内的两个标准去做了一个简单的比较。
He made some comparison to. Okay.
Here, I'll translate.
Yes.
Good.
Go ahead, 你说。
这个在一个标准，就是现在我们国家的标准，中国的标准的一个不燃物级符合版。
哇。
不燃烧的 无机材料做成的板子。
无机 inorganic,
unconventional,
inorganic, 还有什么 ？OK。
它底下有的，英文翻译。
Maybe larger?
你过来看一下。
OK, never mind. I can't read that.我现在介绍一下 ，so we're gonna, he's saying that they come up with their own standard, and there's this is a comparison between the two. So, oh there, non-combustible inorganic compound board. 我们要介绍这个板
啊。不是，我是和这个标准其实做了一个比较
对比。
So they're making a comparison between the
two
standards.
So this will help.
Chinese standard versus
EC 386. 这个另外一个就是咱们，我们建筑用的薄膜板，咱们解释了。建筑做装饰用的。
So
薄膜板用在装饰上。
This 薄膜板 is used for construction.
NGO board. When you say 薄膜板
，NGO board.
We know.Bome ban, we can learn that word.
Peter knows. Mike, do you know that? Okay,
这个提供给我们那个 AC386 啊，今天看了它还有一个 AC367、368，那个我们没见着啊，我只是把386和它去比较。
So in the comparison, they just found out there's AC387 and 388, but they know about 386. So this comparison is just AC386 versus what they do.
Which is fine. One of the others is for gypsum, and one of the others is for ordinary Portland cement board. So they're all similar.
AC387是 gypsum 这个材料。
石膏板。
还有 AC388 是 what was the material?
Ordinary Portland cement board.
另外一个是水泥板，平常的水泥板。
那我们就和它比较就没问题了。
So 我们现在 ，so we're making a comparison between Chinese standard and the AC387.
这个386这个它是2007年的这个出来的一个，它的用途就是适用范围，咱们叫适用范围就是用的领域用的地方。
Okay, so AC387 came out in 2007, and these Chinese words are the usages of this material. So the usages is for construction building the level, what else? Using it for wall, using it for the floor, and using it as a base foundational board within the interior walls.
Yep. This 386, we use it几个方面，这一个是它在结构的一个覆盖，也就是应该是在结构的维护啊。它所谓的这个覆盖，我理解着这个构件做完了以后把它覆盖上去，这可能是这个。
So this wall, from what they understand, is that once the foundation of a building is done, this is the layer after the foundation.
Feathering.
你说。
Foundation.
就比如说昨天看到那个建筑啊，他想着把它就用在外面的，
对
啊，覆盖，那应该就是个结构。你别说这个墙，建起来了以后，他就把它盖上。
咱们叫维护
挂板。
So from what their understanding is, this board goes onto the wall. They're the most exterior surface.
No.
No.
No. The AC386 is for this is outside wall.On this side, if it's on the other side, then it is structural.
是室外还是室内的墙？
386 covers inside and outside.
室内的。
Yeah, you're talking about interior wall.
Not outside.
Yes, it does.
室内。
Because it does not include any structural. And if it's on the outside, it's deemed to be holding up the structure.
No, I'm sorry, I disagree. Magnum specifically got that written in the AC386 ruling, the structural sheathing.
But that may be, but that's not 386.
它这个杆儿啊，是
That's in addition to 386.
但是
386
是
三
八六。Mike 说是只是室内的这个墙。
然后
Peter 说
是
室内室外都可以，所以说这个讨论就是这个话题。
这个上面它
所以你 add the cement board, the only thing the cement board wants is
Magnum didn't do anything with 386.
零七年这个三八六啊
and they did the E72 for transverse
loading. Yeah, they did the E72. The minute you do E72, you can be on the other side.
So, guys, apparently according to EC386 that came out in 2007, it only covers for interior walls, not exterior, only interior. Because he's just explaining what his understanding of EC386 is.
Yeah.
Also, it's to prevent fire. The construction building is to prevent fire. 1, 2, 3, and 4 levels of non-combustible construction.
Yeah. And fifth level construction. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. So there's different grades of this board. So as you can see, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. To for different usage of different types of buildings.
是根据不同的检测数据出来的。选择用不同的等级件。什么意思？就是我们这个玻璃板测出个什么数来，那么根据这个数据才选择它的用途用在哪一个等级上。
He's saying according to the testing of the board, the number that comes out based on that number, they use it for different things.
是这个意思。
The idea is that if you meet 386, you can be used in type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4, and type 5 construction under the code.
Yes.
So you can use it in all the buildings.
Yes, that's what they're saying.
是这个意思，我理解的是这个。再一个，它也不适合在那个长期潮湿的场所，比如说卫生间。 这些长期厨房、长期潮湿的地方，AC386也是不适用的。
And apparently this board is not suitable for areas that is humid, such as the bathroom or the kitchen, where it would be wet or humid long term, from what his understanding is.
这个AC386和咱们那个414比较起来，它实际上涉及到两种板。 我们那个414是三种啊，就是基板、涂料覆盖面的，还有这个贴面的。它这个看了看，它是两类。除了贴面的，我们的基板和刷涂料的，这个它涉及到了。这个是几个板？两个板。
So AC386 has two different types of boards, whereas the Chinese standard, which is the JGT414, covers three different types of boards. So that's the difference. This covers two boards, that covers three boards. This GB25970 came out in 2010, and that's the China's national standard code that we all these manufacturers has to comply by.
这个它的用途呢，就是它没有这个涉及到。 用在什么板上啊？就没笼统的就没提这个事儿。That
code is a general code, so it doesn't say what board is it applicable for.
对，但是它使用的范围是不燃建筑、不燃烧的，比它这个要严格。So
this is a very strict code, and it's applicable for buildings that are non-combustible. So very, very high standards. Actually, he believes it's higher than the AC386, more strict.
那么这个呢，对用在什么场所上没做限制。And
they didn't really determine for what usage, so for what type of building or what room, they didn't really determine what the usage is.
另外这个25970这个标准呢，它没有对我们这个板类做起分类。The GB25970
also didn't determine what boards it's applicable for. That's why that saw as empty.
这个我们这个414呢，414这是建筑工程的标准，在国内的标准啊有这么几类，你一会儿给他讲讲这个事情。这个国标啊是最高标准，然后还有几个行业标准，行业建筑工程的就是这个编号。
建筑物。So the GB1 is a national construction standard. That means every construction type within China has to comply to that standard, which is a very high standard. It's a general national standard. But there's also several industry standards. So the JGT141 is a construction industry standard.
我们这个标准上对它的用的范围呢，我们是用在室内装饰，不是做承载装饰。
Oh, so for usage, they are using it for essentially interior decoration. It's not used as a wall. It's decoration, so it may not be as strong.
我们这个是个装饰。
Yeah.
我们这样做装饰的话，就是对它的防火这一块，我们没去规定它。
Oh, there's no standard for fireproofing because, as he said, it's decorative. It's for interior design. It's not as a structural wall.
这个另外我们也是不适合在卫生间这些长期潮湿的场所，我们也不适用。
Also, not useful for bathroom or kitchen or any humid, long-term humid places.
但是根据装饰效果，我们这里分了三类啊。那边这个386是两类，我们这里还多了一个，比如说贴一个覆面，覆盖面。比如说这个板子顶上贴着一层面。
So in addition to the two over here from AC387, they can also add a surface level, like different type of material surface to the wall. So they have a third level for the board in terms of classification.
这个标准的内容上，都涉及到了尺寸偏差，也就是尺寸。
Dimensions and sizes. So these are the dimensions and sizes, as you can see from the three standards. So AC386, the Chinese national standard, and then the Chinese construction industry standard, those are the dimensions.
这个386的，它是两个基本的规格，这个一米三三四八这个，还有个3米04吧，宽度呢是个1米219。
AC386, this is the length is 2,348 millimeter times the width, 1,219 millimeter, and the thickness is 3.5 to 25 millimeter thick.
Isn't this reversed? Isn't the width first and the length?
第一个是宽还是长？长。No, that's the length. First one is the length, width, and then the thickness.
This is his standard
size. So he's saying that's the standard, but according to the customer's demand, they can change the size and dimensions. But that's just the standard size.
那个不然符合板上他那个尺寸的，他这个小于3米啊，最长不允许3米，就是3米以内的。
So the government national standard has to be less than 3 meters in terms of length.
这个在厚度上，它是最大不允许70毫米。
Oh, the thickest is 70 millimeter. The maximum.
但是最小没有。There's
no standard for how thin it is. It could be very, very, very thin, but the thickness can be over 70 millimeter.
这个我们那个414啊，是我们参照了就是国内用的像石膏板、爆花板这些东西啊，一个基本的一个尺寸，就是2米44，1米22，这么一个基本的尺寸。So
in China, the construction industry uses concrete boards. 林青第二个是什么？爆花板是什么？什么？啊，就你就说你们这儿的那个木板。OBS。
OSB.
So they use a lot of concrete boards and wooden OBS boards.
OSB.
And they have a typical standard. It's the length is 2.4 meters and the width is 1.2 meters and the thickness is 30 or between 30 and 20 millimeter thick.
3 to 20.
3 to 20, yeah.
3 to 20, 3.0.
Oh, that's 3.0,
okay. 3 to 20. 比如说在Peter仓库里边，我们看到了国内运了些板，基本上我看大体就是那个尺寸。
So in Peter's warehouse, he saw that most of the boards were in that type of standard, in that size.
在中国基本上就是那么一个尺寸，2米44一米。That's their typical standard size. 这就是这些尺寸的允许偏差，这三个标准啊都有不同的这个要求。There's
different range and different demands for each of these standards.
这个粗略看了一下，那个414那个应该相对的对尺寸要求严格一些。 但是像 Peter 买进来这个运到加拿大，他还要进行二次加工，二次加工，比如说他要切削这些，对尺寸不应该那么要求那么严格。So
the JGT 414 has very very strict standards in terms of thickness and all that sort of stuff. But once they are imported to Canada or elsewhere, and they're going through processing such as cutting into smaller shapes and whatnot, this
you know, then it's not as strict. 那个昨天Peter在那抱怨，抱怨他是这一摞板里有的厚有的薄，对吧？他在那里一直抱怨的。现在按照17386，他通常板内啊，它是正负15%。这个15%这个数字是不小的。那个还有这个，比如说在。
So yesterday when they were at Peter's warehouse, Peter was complaining how he had a whole stack of boards and there were all different thicknesses. Some were thin, some were thicker, so he was saying it's inconsistent. So Mr. Wang is saying the AC386 standard, the thickness allows 15% difference in terms of thickness. 15% is quite a bit. So it ranges from 3.5 to 5 millimeter, plus or minus 0.5 millimeter in terms of thickness.
比如说他那些板，他基本上是在10到16毫米左右。
His boards were between 10 to 16 millimeter. Yes.
Is that within one board?
这个是就一个板吗？啊，一块板。Yeah, the same board, different thickness.
他那里的要求。No.
王总，他是问的是这个一个板上有这么厚度的差吗？不是，不是板一板之间，板一板厚度。Sorry, different, like same material board, different thickness. Not the same board from one thick to another.
No, 1186 specification. 785 is testing. 386 doesn't have dimension tolerance as well.
Oh, yeah. 如果是按照这个理解的话，它的应该正负偏差是1.5毫米。
So 15% of between 10 to 16 millimeter on average is about 1.5 millimeter, give or take.
不同板之间。
Between the boards.
这个414那个，但大家看那些数据相对的就比它严格一些，因为我们的用途是装饰。
So the JGT 414 standard is actually stricter than the AC 386. So,
you要介绍这个四。这个再一个就是那个外观质量，也就是 Peter 所关心的那个不同版的色差问题，啊。
So now we're talking about the look and feel of these boards. Because Peter was saying yesterday that there was variation in the coloring of these boards yesterday.
他这个也是比较笼统的一个提法，你比如说他就要求这个均质啊，并且没有什么重大的缺陷。这个重大缺陷应该就是比如说破损呐、断裂这些的应该是。So
keep in mind, these are broad strokes. So the AC386, they demand the boards can't have any cracks or chips in it, so it has to look even and complete in the look.
那个，因为不然无极复合板的那个标准，就中间的那个， 我们提的也是比较笼统啊，但是对这些这个外观上的缺陷，比如说孔洞这些做了些限制。
So the GB, the Chinese National Standard, is a little bit more detailed, but still very broad. So it says the surface has to be complete and flat. It can't have any cracks. It cannot have any splits. It cannot have any chips or missing corners. But also bubbles, no bubbles, and no holes, and no divots in the board, which is not included in the AC386.
这个414这个标准对外观上就没有过做过多的要求，但是对那个只是一个笼统的平整边角整齐。
So the industry standard in China, the JGT4414 in terms of the look, they just want it to be complete, no missing corners, you know, like it's more broad in terms of the look.
这个在物理性能这上面，这几个标准啊，有的交叉，有的它有，它没有。第一个就是抗折强度。
林青，你能介绍这一段吗？我这个不太懂。
Alice, can you go back to the tolerances?
我们可以回去，它有一个问题，回过去一个
误差那一块。
The look? Is it the looks page?
Tolerance.
It's in here.
Okay, the tolerance, AC 386 does not specify tolerance. It refers to ASTM C 1186. So...
These are sizes.
They're not,
is that what you're talking about?
They're not in the AC 386. I have AC 386. It doesn't say anything. It says, for tolerances, go to... C1186.
ASTM.
ASTM. So when you go here, it tells you what the tolerances are, and they are shown here for...
But remember, 1186 is specification. It tested to 1185.
Yeah.
This is all not...
So there's a thickness tolerance. So maximum is 10%.
10%,
it's
not 15%.
Not 15, and it's less when the board is thinner.
Misdirected.
So we can give a copy.
那他大家听好了。这个 AC 386其实没有说要多厚、多宽这个，他只是说要看另外一个标准，另外一个标准叫118。Is this 1185?
86.
1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186.
1186.
1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186.
1186.
1186. 1186.
1186. 1186. 1186. 1186. 1186.
So
the comparison.
Yeah, Peter, comparison is one thing, when it's completely different.
Well,
I'm sorry, but I don't even drag it down, but what he's saying right now is completely not true.
But
even when they're coming into Canada, you cannot bring your board without a plane spread. You're saying that,
yeah, we know that.
It is more stringent than the Canadian.
That's why we're developing the Boca standard, because
I don't know. I want you guys to, when you're comparing apples and apples, I'm very passionate about what I hear, and I'm here for a reason. But this, what he's saying, what reality is not nothing compared to what he's saying.
The first one is flexural strength. Okay.
这个抗折强度呢 ，AC 386要求是个2.0，我们那个最小是个6，是吧，张峰
？It's above 2 and ours is 6.
那个是个1.5。
And the other one is 1.5. And
The
flex flectual strength after absorption of water. EC386 does not have any thing mentioned about it, and only our national standard has something to say. It's above 70.
这个动容循环，我们国内两个标准都没有做规定。这个，它这个386有。
About the freeze and the thaw cycling, we do not have any regulation, and the 386 has the regulation.
这个我们那边的翻译出来了，它动容循环了以后呢，它的指标要求就是不可分解。It
is this.
这个我估计这个标准啊，应该把它明确，应该明确，不可分解。
不好一点。哦。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个。这个 real usage.
这个潮湿变形受潮以后啊，这个板的变形情况，你比如用在天花板吊顶的时候，受潮以后它会下垂的。And
after it absorbs water, it will change, and the form of this board will change. For example, if you use it for seating, after it absorbs water, and then the seating will be same.
这三个标准都做了规定啊，但是略有不同。
Regulations, little difference.
这个吸水性和我们这个
water absorption.
这个吸水性啊，实际上我们叫个吸水率。 就吸水以后的比率
ratio of water absorption.
这个 AC386在这个吸水上做了这个要求，做了规定，要测这个指标，但是没有说吸多少。
386 has a regulation about it, but it doesn't say clearly how much it is.
这个不燃无机复合板没做要求。The
non-combustible in organic board has no regulation about that. On the in organic board.
这个414那个标准上分了三类，分别都做出了一个吸水率的要求。414
has regulations for in this regulation. It divides the boards into three kinds and has given three data for each board.
这三个数据啊，分别就是最小的15%。
The minimum one is 15%.
这个 Michael 这个资料上，他希望做到10%。
And according to Mike, in his material,
他想法是10%，这个10%这个数据啊，是比较苛刻的，比较严格。
It is very restrict.
达不到。
John says it's impossible to reach that data.
来，这个。 AC386对这个压缩压痕，它有贯穿阻力。贯穿阻力。我理解的它这个贯穿阻力，它那个做法也是用个瓦楞钉去打透它。有个力。
Pull through.
Nail pull through. 是这个意思吧？
Nail pull through. Yes.
它对这两个做了要求，我们也没。 在这上面没做要求。
We do not have any regulations on that two kind of.
这个压缩压痕啊，主要就是看我们这个板儿的表面的硬度。
For the impact, it is a data for the strength for the board, so in the strength.
对，因为我们那两个标准，它的定位的用途，比如说我们那个414是做装饰的，所以我们对这块没去考虑。但我们的氧化镁板啊。通过它这个指标应该问题不大。
Because one of our regulations is based on the decoration board, so we didn't make that kind of regulation for our MGO board. It is easy to reach the standard.
这个它这个贯穿阻力，我们414里边有一个握定力。啊，我们叫个握定力。
We call it nail pull through. Yes. Yes.
就是他们可能他这个就是希望他往里拧的时候越难拧越好。
It's better to when you nail the when you screw the nail in, the harder the better.
我们这个呢，侧重的什么？这个螺钉拧进去以后，越难拔越好。
And ours is our standard focus on.You nail, you screw in, and when you pull out through, the harder the better.
拔出力。
One is pulling, it's hard to pull, to nail in, the other is harder to pull out, pull through.
这是不同啊，就是。
That's the difference.
Yeah. 它这还有个落球冲击。
Falling ball impact.
那个落球冲击就是看这个板脆不脆。
And it showed the strength of the board.
我们没有。
对，
我们没有做要求。
We do not have a request on that.
这个386它这个，因为它还有一个施工阀位，它可以做地板用。
386, it has another usage. It's for floor.
这个我们那两个标准没有这个地板这个功能。
We do not have.This kind of usage.
所以他提这个落球是有道理的。我们那个因为，
so, it is reasonable for
因为波
这里
用，所以落球也落不到地下。
We do not use it in this way, so we do not do this kind of test.
这个他呢还有些特殊要求啊，就是
special request.
对水泥聚合物、水泥砂浆的粘接。
Cement and cement 粘接
就是两块板粘到一起，中间的这个粘接胶是用的水泥
粘。As cement as adhesive
bonding strength.
Yes, bonding strength.
它是粘到一起啊，它这个剪切，剪切它。
Shear, yes, shear.
我们那两个标准在这些方面没有去考虑的。
We do not have this kind of regulation.
因为我们比如说做装饰的时候啊，我们基本上是跑固啊，当初没考虑这一块儿。
So we use this board as decoration, so we didn't put this into consideration.
这个潮湿变形。潮湿变形怎么理解？前边有一个细水前面弄重了，就受潮以后下垂的。
这两个是一样的。
这俩是一样的。
As he has already mentioned that when the board gets wet, it absorbs
water. Is it by deflection or deflection?
He says he has already mentioned that this one is already.
这个再一个比较重要的指标就是这个表面的这个燃烧。 燃烧 AC 三八六啊，它是用这个表面燃烧。
In 386, it mentioned that surface burning.
Surface burning.
Surface burning.
表面。我们那两个标准是，我们是用的是整板的燃烧。
In our national standard, we are saying about the whole piece burning for the whole piece.
因为它这个 ASTM 八四这个标准啊，我们也没得到，但是看了看它。
We do not know what the 48 standard says.
这个它现在这个测试呢，就是用的是个火焰扩散指数，火焰的扩散指数是不是刚才看到的那个大长箱子？这个我们也不清楚它怎么测。
He does not know what the flame extension data means. He guess maybe it is something we saw in the lab. Yes.
是吧？这个这两天有一个，
你如果想知道，麦克可以解释给你。
这个还是还有一个烟密度。昨天麦克。昨天麦克给我们讲了哈，就是那20%燃烧失重，20%通不过，但是它可以通过另外一个变通的方式，估计就是这里。
Mike, you mentioned that yesterday you mentioned the 20%, we cannot pass that, but he's suggesting
is, the 20% is different than the E84.
他说这个20%这个跟这个 ，no， let him finish。
Okay.
He says that since it's impossible for us to pass the 24 standard, 20% standard, we can try this smoke density, smoke density, smoke expense,
smoke develop.
Develop.
This is an easy test.
这个实验很简单的 84. I'm sorry.
So what the 10 is 1/10 as much burning as wood.
Okay. 那说就是说，这个八四这个测试是是指10%，是木头燃烧的10%。10%.
10% of wood.
Of wood.
Red oak.
也就是是不是就是他昨天说的那个另外一个方式，通过这个。
Is this the method you once mentioned yesterday?
It's one that I mentioned, but this is at the end of the presentation. The main criteria that we were talking about yesterday was combustible versus non-combustible, and that's the ASTM E136 that had the 50% weight loss.And the Canadian version had the 20% weight loss.
Okay, 昨天咱主要是讲的就是不燃性、可燃性的这个东西，
这个加拿大的。我们国内的两个标准，我们国内有一个燃烧的分类分级啊，那个并且是个强制标准。
We have a kind of regulation that which is compulsory. Okay.
我们那个是按照那个的分级啊。25970这个就不然，它就是不然就是 A 级啊。
N 级。
A
哦哦哦，for our national standard, it is non-combustible and it is called it is classified into A grade.
这个414呢，根据它的市面不同，我们分了三个级。
In 414, we classified the boards into three grades.
这个最低的那个等级啊，也就是我们装饰面有一种贴面，有一种贴面的当贴木板的时候，贴木板的时候是一个放到个 B 级。这是最低的一个啊。
The lowest grade is B1, grade B1, with a cover on the board.
我们四幺四那些标准上，我们国内的标准上，因为对氧化煤板，我们有一些抗翻路性的要求。
We also have an important request on halogenation.
这个四幺四的，这个三八六的这个没多要求。
In 386, there is no such regulation.
这个还有个氯离子溶出量。
And the chloride content, you do not have this kind of regulation either.
这个前两个，这个386和那个国标都没有。 这个我们对氯离子溶出量做了一个要求。
In our national, in our national standard, we do not have this regulation, but in T414, there is such regulation.
这个Michael这个稿上可能对这个指标也开始重视了。Michael, maybe
you will.
氯离子，它要参照688这个标准，有个5%。
In our national standard, it's 5%. It's 5%.
Chloride is 5%.
Chloride, dissolved chloride, this, which can be, you can test in the water.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
这个四幺四这个标准呢，这个指标啊，我们当初定了个1.5这个指标，但这个指标有点不大科学啊。
过于严格。
And for the 1.5 in 414, it is too restrict. This number is too restrict. Too low. Yeah.
这不是too low.
Too high. Too high.
No.
Not too low. Too high.
Too high.
What do we? So what is the 1.54?
它能达到百分之二。
比较合理的、苛刻的、比较正常的一个指标3%。
对呀、啊，还是太少了，你还太。
不，水平太低还是指数太低？他说低，你说高。Anyway,
Michael，如果是制定这个标准的时候，这个指标至少要放到3%。
The
reasonable number when you do your standard, the reasonable number he's suggesting is 3%.
For dissolved chlorides.
Yes.
就溶出氯离子。对。他要引用688。对对对对，这个，这我要给他解释这个哈。What
to explain?
这个标准上，他想用这个688放到5%。
And for our national, you refer, when you make this MOCA standard, you refer to our national standard.
5%更严了，这个。
866, and it's 5%. Our
这个这是不可以。
5%. It's even more restrict, 更严了。
你看这个五，我说这里要放到三，他再用个五，我说他还严在哪里呢？因为这个它是氯离子含量。Okay,
because he wants to explain why he thinks it is even more restrict because in our national standard it's the content of chloride, not dissolved chloride.
I see. Test different tests.
Yes.
啊，这个不一样的啊。 含量就是指那个原料整个这个产品当中含的氯的成分的总量。Yeah,
the content is a general number. Add up all the chloride.
Okay. 按照这个5%这个数啊，那么我们的摩尔比都是不匹配的。在这个里边，最好定的时候啊，要参照我们那个放到3。So 3,
that's what he's suggesting.
Now 3 dissolved or 3? Yeah.
是溶出的。溶出。 Yeah,
dissolved. 这个含水率这些的，他们386什么没多要求啊，这含水率、干水率。
The water content and dryness. And surface, you do not have any regulation about that, about those, okay?
这个表面它有一个表面性能，因为我们是当初有一个贴面板。
When we made this regulation, we were considering that a kind of decoration board, surface board.
就从 Mike 这个 Peter 将来的用途来讲，他也不可能要那些东西来，是吧？所以在这个标准上也不建议。
You do not use it in that way, so you can escape it, pass it.
这个再一个，它的一些有卫生指标啊，环保指标。Other
requirement, other data about environmental request, environment friendly, environment protection data.
环保指标，这个这两个标准都没有，我们那个414因为装饰都用在室内。
Because our 414 standard is for the decoration. It is used, all the boards are used in indoors. So people are concerned about the environment.
Outgassing, you're talking
gassing,
about?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. So we have some regulation about that.
这个也就是能够凸显出我们氧化镁板。 薄镁板的这个它的优势优点。It
will show our advantage of the MG board.
那个它这个衡量的指标啊，就是放射性，内照射指数、外照射指数。They
are testing about radiation in and out. Terms.
When you say radiation, you mean heat?
No,
radiation.
X-ray.
Radioactive.
明白了。啊，正常的建筑材料，这个内照射指数都在一，外照射指数1.5、1.3。
He's comparing the data for common construction material. The upper one, which shows 0 point, is commonly 1. For common construction material, and the outside data for the 0.3 is 1.3 or 1.4, so it's much better.
对，那是正常的啊。但是我们这个氧化镁板呢，在这个指标上都没有问题，0.3。这是我们的优点。这个甲醛释放量，因为我们那个板有一些木制作的，就是铺的木皮，所以。 钉上一个，它这个应该可以也不低。
Maybe you do not need to have the last data because we will put on some wood cover surface. So we made some regulation about the gas, which is harmful to people. So maybe you do not need this regulation because you do not use it in this way.
Well, we want to use it in a lot of different ways, so we're looking at developing...
You have a lot of wood. We do not have wood, so we,
right.
we put on the cover similar, look similar like wood.
Right, right, fake wood,
so
wood. Yeah.
No, we put on...
We do too.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
这个这就是这三个标准呢，简单的我自己做了一下比较哈。So
he made the comparison among the three standards.
希望对 Michael 编这个标准有所帮助。It
hopes it will help you in your
yes.
正好也插个空哈，谢谢。
Thank you.